Previously on Love and Marriage DC.
Bitch, you didn't make me. You're saying we wouldn't be here if it wasn't
you
for
you. Wouldn't be on Love and Marriage
bitch,
DC.
I don't give a about this shit.
I'm gonna let you know this one time.
You are
not. I'm not nobody else.
Rewind. Ashley Silva is telling her own story in a new book. I am exhausted both emotionally and physically.
Like, I'm not getting any rest. Like, my insomnia is kicking my tail.
Just feel like I've just been working and I haven't been able to just be excited.
Oh, you fell down the damn steps.
Jamie has been retired.
I got going on in my head, too.
When you get sauce, you turn to a different Jamie.
I'm telling you what we're going to do. Are you clear?
But you don't, you don't think that's a problem?
No, that's not a problem. I ain't fighting nobody. Man, stop playing with me, Shane. What you want to do?
I'm going to find you a job or a hobby or something.
Ciao. I told you about the guy that I met at the podcast.
Do you find winter attractive?
Absolutely.
So we've been communicating.
Oh.
Thank you. I love me a good, black, smart, educated man.
Hello.
She seems happier. I hope you her down. Thank God.
It's Joy.
I'm Joy.
And I'm Clifton.
And we met on Ready to Love.
What about the wedding?
I'm about to say, I need your help.
It was supposed to be like the most important day of a woman's life.
But that also means I never really wanted to have a wedding.
Y'all saying black, I invited black.
Who is black again?
Shirella's husband.
Black and Joy were in a band together.
I feel like Joy has a problem with me.
Oh, I can't stand your husband.
Oh, well, that's fine. You don't have to stand him.
Oh, I know.
You really don't.
In this group of people, the only person I technically have is Arena.
You need to learn how to walk away.
She was saying she has a problem with your husband, bro, not with you.
I am sick of Arena and everybody's business. She loves spreading mess.
It just don't look right.
I'm talking to Ashley.
And I'm talking to you.
But I just want you to stay the out of that. She specifically said shady.
I never use the word shady.
Use the words that she said.
You do.
Arena need to take her ass out of it.
I really do want to get past this period where we're blowing up at every single space that we're in.
I just want there to be peace in the Northeast.
Ashley and I definitely have had our ups and our downs.
Watch your back with that one.
You know, she's tricky. She's tricky.
Are they married?
Alicia asked, were y'all already married? Yeah. I said yes.
You did?
Let's just say at cycling class, Ashley brings it up.
Damn. It wasn't a secret, right? But it's our business.
You apologize multiple times.
There's right. No reason to apologize anymore.
It is up to me when I choose to have a conversation. And when will that be? When I'm ready.
Oh, wait the up.
I wasn't expecting for her to come.
You didn't tell me you were coming. I've apologized twice.
Okay. Ain't much more I can do with that.
I brought you into the show.
What, you made me or something?
No, get the out.
No problem.
I'm clueless. I don't know what happened between her and Joy.
You okay?
Raina, get the my face.
Get out your face. Are you kidding me right now?
No, you're not.
I am hurt and I'm confused. I went straight through the door because I saw Joy. I didn't see Ashley. So I'm going to check on Joy because that's the person I saw first. I come back in the house. Ashley's upset because I went to check on Joy first, which is crazy to me and it's very childish.
That's a shame. I thought you guys were really going to talk it out. No, she had a point to make. Her point was that this opportunity would not be here if it wasn't for her. Okay, so thank you for the drama. Thank you for the bull. Thank you for the negativity. Thank you for all of these motherfucking friends, real friends, fake friends, whatever who these motherfucking friends. Thank you. Enemies, bitch. Enemies.
Just come on back downstairs.
That's not fun.
I'm checking on both of y'all.
Arena, you see what the
happened.
Right, you walk right past me and you walk to Joy.
Y'all both are my friends. Yes. I'm trying to see what's good with both of y'all.
You didn't even ask me what happened.
Well, I'm asking you now.
What the f happened?
She's like, well, I don't understand, and whatever, we're building this friendship, something, bitch. One thing you're not gonna do is call me a bitch up in here, up in my mother house. Hey, bitch, when you on this mother show, because of me, and that's the truth.
But that's not true.
Yeah, it is.
No, Jamie and I pitched her as well.
After I pitched her.
Now, Jamie, you talked about it.
But we pitched her too.
So stop.
Listen, Rena, it is what it is.
You're doing too much.
No. You're doing less. You're not doing enough.
But you're doing too much.
You're not doing enough.
You're doing too much.
Rena, keep your hand on my face. Put your hand down. Keep your hands down right now.
Listen.
Rena, don't put your hands up to me. I'm not doing that to you.
See, I can do what I want.
Okay, so put them up again.
So I'm not really feeling that Arena decided to run out and check out on Joy. I just literally gave her the D and our friend.
Now since Jamie has given you the D, I will also give you the D on the end of friend.
I am hurt. I am disappointed. I feel betrayed. The picture's clear now. Where your loyalty lies. It's f***ed up.
Bob or no Bob, Ray Ray is here. If you take me there, Ray Ray is coming.
Stop. I'm not doing this with you. You get the f*** out
of
here. Listen. Well, Raina, can I talk to you outside?
Hold up,
come on.
What the f***?
Real life. That's enough.
Quick.
Hey, babe.
Can you come help me finish cleaning up, please?
Jesus Christ.
Surprisingly, it is not as bad as I thought it was going to be.
I feel like it definitely seemed a lot worse. We had a time last night, though. I tell you that, we definitely had a time. Literally.
Christmas Eve at the Silvers is a tradition that's almost been 15 years old.
15 years.
We've never reiterate that. We've never had an incident at our home at the Christmas Eve's Eve. Ain't the time for that.
It's definitely is not the time. We are supposed to be celebrating Jesus' birthday, okay?
Right. Amen.
We having a great time, and all of a sudden, I see Joy walk in. First person.
I didn't see Joy walk in. That's the problem.
Did you invite Joy?
No, when I invited everybody, Joy was invited. But...
But y'all haven't talked.
Right. After the whole, you know, I told Alicia she was married thing, she's been avoiding me.
Right.
So I'm assuming she's not coming. Yeah. I'm just like looking around.
Right.
And I was like, I know Joy ain't walk in my house and ain't come speak and say nothing. Like, that's a problem. Well, she should have been at the hospital taking care of her husband. She shouldn't have even been here. Under the city lights,
where it all yes.
Ready?
Good job.
You know, I've been in the hospital. I'm still not fully walking properly. I need a real meal today.
So, I take my baby out and get a little air, a little sunshine.
Beautiful day. Had to break you out.
Thank you. I need to get out of there. It's like prison.
I didn't want to leave you last night.
So what did I miss, you know?
Oh, well, my love. I came in with every intentions of, you know what? Let's get everything out on the table. Let's be able to, you know, still be able to be in the same room, be cool, da-da-da-da-da.
Right.
That was not what was on the agenda.
Good morning. How are you? You look tired.
Why are you so bright-eyed and bushy-tailed?
My adrenaline was really high last night, and I haven't been able to sleep.
What the hell was all that about?
What the hell happened?
I'm asking you.
After that blew up last night, I feel like that party ended up being a complete show.
So what you had? What popped off?
So I saw Ashley pull Joy's arm,
and walk away like they were going to have a conversation. A couple of minutes later, I hear all this chaos. Did you hear all this chaos in the other room?
It sounded like furniture was flipping over. And...
I never thought that the holiday party would have went down like that. Never.
This is my first time actually having a conversation about her sharing the information about us being married. Mm-hmm. And even then, there was no sign of like her being remorseful or that she even really freaking cared.
Right, right.
You know what I mean? It was kind of like, okay, whatever. Like, you know, I said I'm sorry. You know what I mean? It's one of those things.
Oh, like, sorry, but I ain't really sorry.
In a sense, yeah.
Okay, okay. She baited you, right?
She baited the shit out of me.
As to be a friend to learn about you and then you against you. So she ain't sorry.
In Ashley's presence, I never felt her sorry. I never felt remorse. I never felt as if that's something to be true. It's not about what you say. It's how you say it.
All I heard was bitch. And after that, I'm like, lost, not cool.
She ain't call you no bitch.
She did, that's why I got upset.
I've never been disrespected in my own house, like, especially from someone who I cared about. So now I'm a bitch, all right, bitch activated.
She also mentioned, this was the good part right here.
Okay.
That we would not be here in this setting if it wasn't for her.
Coming up on Love and Marriage, D.C.
You was on.
Because I felt like she needed the slapped out of her. That's what I felt. I felt like she wanted a Christmas present.
I did call her my enemy.
And you meant it, otherwise you wouldn't have said it.
Yeah, you drew the line.
Yeah.
Joy, a little disrespectful ass, came up in my house. You ran out after her. That bothered me.
It could have been me leaving and not coming back. She also mentioned, this was the good part right here.
Okay.
That we would not be here in this setting if it wasn't for her.
She done lost her mind. What?
Like, bitch, you done made us. Now you're sitting on this imaginary pedestal and that we're supposed to be thanking you like we're like minions.
Why are Actually, you so we're not here because of her either. We're here because unless she's Carlos King, who makes the final decision, which she is not, who has to say this? So then, well, how did it end up? Well, you know, how did it end?
Oh, I got kicked out.
By the Christmas party. by who?
By Ashley. I got kicked out. I came in peace. She wanted to sit here and start some and you know what? She got it.
And if I could really roll my eyes like she did that first night at Jason's going away party, I would, but I'm not six, so there you go.
And I hear, you know, everybody, y'all screaming at each other. And I'm like, what the hell is going on? You was on.
Because I felt like she needed the slapped out of her. That's what I felt. I felt like she wanted a Christmas present. So I'm like, you need to get out. Like, you can leave.
It was better for Joy to leave before things went even more left than they had already gone.
What the hell happened to you and Raina?
Raina ran out the door chasing behind Joy like Joy was a sad little innocent puppy. Which she wasn't.
Are they cool like that?
Obviously.
Well, I didn't.
I don't like that she went out there running behind Joy. I don't like that. That's why I'm like, Raina, you can stay right out there with her then.
No, I don't like that for you and the Raina.
I don't like that for me and the Raina either, but what you going out there checking on her for when she came in my house being disrespectful?
And then once again, you caught in the middle of all this.
So then I had to hear Ashley's story. So then she talks about, again, how she brought Joy around. If it wasn't for her, they wouldn't be here.
Does she know you had input on that, too?
Joy knows that.
I'm talking about Ashley.
Ashley knows that, too.
So why'd she say that?
I don't know. It was almost like she was saying I had something to do with it and nobody else. Like, Joy should be kissing her feet because if it wasn't for her, she wouldn't be in the group. So...
You think it's some hidden little jealousy or hate with them?
I mean, it could be a little bit of jealousy. I keep hearing things like, oh, you're with Joy. Oh, you're with your best friend. Oh, okay, so go hang with Joy. Oh, you were with your best friend last night. I have to constantly keep hearing these things from Ashley, so I think it's a little jealousy.
I gave her, you know, jokingly, I gave her a D yesterday to signify the D in our friendship.
You giving grades then?
No. The D was to signify the D in friend. I am since reneging that. That D means nothing. It does not exist anymore.
No, don't do that. Not what you
Yes, do that. Babe, but
And you saw how she was acting, even with that, then she's coming in and she all waving her hands. And that's why, and so because she is a Raina, because I do love her, because I got respect for her, that's why I was telling her, like, Raina, stop, put your hand down. And every time I said put your hand down, she kept putting her hand up more and more and more. I guess she wanna prove how big and bad she is.
You don't take sides. You don't jump to someone else's defense. You don't go running out the door behind somebody who came into someone else's house and has been disrespectful. You don't do that.
That I agree.
All I know is I feel like everybody has just been poking the bear.
Right.
And now I feel like the mean girl's back.
Mean girl Ashley's back?
Nobody wants that.
I did call her my enemy. I did, because you, bitch, you ain't for me.
Nah.
You ain't riding for me. Everything you said right there, you drew the motherfucking line.
And you meant it, otherwise you wouldn't have said it.
Yeah, you drew the line.
Yeah.
What I said is what I said, because when you sit there and poke the bear, y'all done poked me this whole entire time. This is what you get. Stop with me.
Coming up.
How do you really feel about maintaining this?
Abstinence?
Yes.
It's not for the faint of heart.
My strength is in not buying the cookies from the cookie aisle. But if there are cookies in my house, I'm going to eat them.
Let's go.
Happy New Year.
Be careful.
I'm already down.
I told you.
But I'm up. But I
You Yo. Gotta stop me from picking crap like this.
Listen, I got you.
This is not a good idea.
Yusha and I have been dating for a few months now. Things are going amazing.
Look at you, picking up speed.
We talk every day, multiple times a day. We have spent his birthday together, and we've spent Christmas together, which was really, really nice and sweet.
Oh, shoot.
Just feels like things are evolving organically and evolving in the right direction, and the feels are happening. And the L word may be Ellen in the picture.
Babe, I think we need to take a break. My knees, my thighs are all burning. You good?
Yeah.
Look at you. You actually did better than me.
How you feeling?
Accomplished.
We still got a little bit to go, but I'm gonna give us some grace.
So let's talk about us. It's been a few months.
Mm-hmm.
I do feel like it's probably time that you start meeting some pretty important people. I just feel like my kids are starting to ask more questions. I always start with Kayla first.
I think it's time for us to start to dabble into meeting the family.
Yeah.
And just doing some of the things that allow us to really see if we are the cohesive pair that we appear to be.
Introducing children is a huge step in the relationship. It has to be worth it. I have to know that this relationship is something that I'm going to entertain for a long period of time. And so we've had very intentional discussions. So I think we can handle it.
Handle it? I've never done it before, right? So
Ooh.
The exact challenge, I don't know, but it's like all challenges in life. We'll do it together. We'll figure it out. So we've been talking for some time.
Uh-huh.
And I want to get a clear answer on this. How do you really feel about maintaining this, you know?
Abstinence?
Yes. How long you want to do this?
The goal is until marriage. It's not as hard for me as it may be for other people because I've practiced it before. I just try to do my best not to tempt you.
Look, this is my analogy. I always tell you, my strength is in not buying the cookies from the cookie aisle. But if there are cookies in my house, I'm gonna eat them. And you was in my house.
We've been spending a lot of time with each other, even staying the night over each other's houses. And no, we have not done the do. The deed has not been done.
I'm still solid on the idea that we need to wait till marriage. I think as a man, I have my moments, but I truly believe that the outcome will be a lot more blessed if we do it God's way. I'm committed to that, no matter how tough it is, no matter how hard it gets.
I'm proud of us.
It definitely is not for the faint of heart.
No, I'm happy for the decision. I just want to make sure we aligned in that way.
Which is why I advocate for waiting until marriage. So I'm locked in, I'm locked in.
If marriage is the ultimate destination, then I want you to know I'm 100% cool with that.
Okay.
That's what my mind and my spirit is saying. Just check me on the days when my body take over.
I'll check you. I'll definitely hold you accountable.
Highly sexy when a man can be intentional about how he pursues relationships. I'm happy to see it.
I wanted to address something with you because we've had a lot of conversation. I love that you're an alpha male, sexy to me, but that sometimes comes with not expressing through words. I think you're an action-oriented person, which I appreciate. I love that. But as a woman who's a words of affirmation when it comes to her love language, I would love to hear you express more.
Yusha and I have gotten to the place in our relationship where we're starting to develop strong feelings for each other. In fact, I told Yusha that I loved him. Yusha's response, and I quote, was, "I appreciate that. Thank you for sharing that with me." I don't know, it didn't feel good.
I know your love language is words of affirmation.
It is.
I do. We can have all the words in the world to, you know, speak intelligently and profound. But when it comes to the matters of the heart, it can get a little difficult. And sometimes the fear that you have about not being out there by yourself can be expressed in sometimes my lack of ability to speak. But I'm working on it. And I'm gonna continue to grow and build and understand how to speak to you in the ways that you need to be spoken to.
Thank you.
But also I need you to know that, like, I'm gonna care for you. I'm gonna be there. I'm gonna watch out for you. That's kind of how I naturally express love.
Mm-hmm.
So watch out for those things too, because I'm gonna be right there with you.
I see that, and I appreciate it. And thank you for at least hearing me out and working on it.
I appreciate you too.
Can I have a kiss?
For sure.
Here we go.
I kicked my leg up a little bit too.
Ridiculous.
You ready?
I'm ready.
Come on, let me let you get to the wall.
Okay.
Coming up.
Missed you, man, at the Christmas Eve at the Silvers. Went from talking to all you have, ma, 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 ma.
So I'm glad I wasn't there, because it could have been bad or worse.
I got a swagger on the level 10. If your swag ain't up to par, then why should we pretend? So all you swagging amateurs, we do not let them in. Tell your friends, sister, brother, and your mama too. Swagger jacking, I'ma show what drama do. What that drama be? All this money, it be drowning me. I'm a swagging prodigy, no need for no apologies.
I got somebody come here, meet me here.
Okay, that's fine.
But when I look at y'all, all I see is carbon copies. I'm the master. They try to jack you because I got the swag.
Thank you.
Oh, man.
Morning.
Good guy.
I'm meeting Clifton here today. I'm hoping me and Clifton can get down to the root of where's all this animosity coming from with Ashley and Joy. At one point, I feel like they were cordial and building a friendship, and now it's this. They had to be physically pulled apart from almost fighting. That's unacceptable.
This your first time here?
Not yet, I've never been here.
Yeah.
Food's good?
Food is amazing. So I'm glad you're back on your feet. Did they ever figure out exactly, like, what triggered everything?
So I had some blood clots that ended up, like, getting on the nerves of my spine.
Right.
Preventing me from, like, walking, so they said until they broke up. And I wouldn't be able to stand up straight, you know, do any regular.
Do a lot of physical therapy?
Yeah, so like, I'm in that like three days a week. I haven't slept much, going to physical therapy. This back surgery was no joke. I thought I was gonna be in and out. It wasn't. My recovery's been a little slower than what I expected it to be. But quick restyle, he wanted to chop it up about what happened at the Christmas Eve party about the ladies, our ladies. Well, thank you. We can have a discussion, but if it was the other way around, I would let Ashley and Joy handle it. I'm not interjecting here.
Missed you, man, at the Christmas Eve at the Silvers.
I heard about it.
It was interesting how things unfolded.
Did you see what happened?
Joy walks in. She ain't like walking and making a scene like, hey, I'm here, everybody. Just came in. Ashley goes to her. Like, yo, hello, you in my house? I mean, I ain't spoke to you in weeks. That's literally how, like, she didn't speak to Ashley, she didn't speak to another.
That doesn't seem right to me, but.
You know, Ashley pulled into the other room, they started talking. I feel like it was 5 seconds. But from talking to all you have, ma, 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 ma.
So I'm glad I wasn't there, because it could have been bad or worse.
But what is that supposed to mean? I'm confused on that one.
For me, another reason why I want us to sit, me and you to rap is that, like, figure out where all this started. And once again, you tell me your side, this is my understanding. Joy told Ashley that, you know, y'all were married, and she said something to her best friend, Alicia. From that, Joy, like, flipped, like, why would you tell her we married?
Right. Joy shared something with her Ashley in confidence.
Right.
Right? About us, our personal life, right? Mm-hmm. Ashley brought it up in an audience. You would think that if you share something with somebody in confidence, that it stays with that person.
So did Joy say, like, don't say nothing?
Absolutely.
But Ashley, I think Ashley, when she found out Joy was upset, she apologized. She apologized a number of times. I mean, I'll tell you, when I know about my wife apologized once, and Lizzie, if you don't accept it, she keep moving.
If I do something wrong to someone, no, I can't dictate how they forgive me. If I apologize, it's up to them when they accept it, how they feel and how they move forward. It has nothing to do with me.
She didn't feel that it was genuine. You have a friend that you're trusting and you're building.
But they're not friends.
You can't use that as an excuse.
Yeah, but they're not friends.
Okay, so they were building a friendship. Let's say that. So we fell in love on TV, so we wanted something just to have for us.
You feel like Ashley spoiled your moment. Like,
absolutely.
Now y'all can't have the wedding.
We can still have the wedding, but it's like the excitement would be gone. If you're looking at a totem pole excitement level, it ain't gonna be the same excitement level. So originally we've probably been here for people that actually wanted to see. Now it's gonna be down here.
I understand you. But for me, if I don't want nobody to know, don't say nothing.
I wouldn't tell you something that I'm gonna think is gonna go somewhere else. Right.
But I wouldn't tell you something that I didn't want to get out there. Like,
but if you said in confidence, right, and you think that we building a friendship, right, mm-hmm. you would think that that person that you're talking to, the same way that you're telling me that you would hold the information that I'm giving you,
right.
that it would stay there. If I tell you something today, I'm like, yo, don't tell nobody, you're gonna go tell them?
I'm gonna tell you, don't tell me that. Don't
come
tell
on, man.
Me. But
don't do that. Of course he's gonna take up for her. I mean, I don't expect anything less. However, was Ashley wrong? Hell yeah. So to me, I'm like, all right, well, now is she a target?
Joy's a target.
Yes. Maybe she feels some kind of way about Joy.
Like, but jealousy, but like,
is it like a threat that we hear we came from another show? Or is it, you know, competition? You know what I'm saying? One keep the other leg up higher than the other one.
Like, come on, Joy and Clifton. Like, y'all believe that the Silvers are using the Petties for a come up. Okay, all right. If y'all believe that, I got some waterfront property in the Sahara Desert that I'm selling right now for dirt cheap. I'll sell it to y'all, because y'all believe anything. If Joy and Ashley don't rock, where does that leave Clifton to quit?
I don't get involved in women's business.
Me neither, like, never.
You know, of course, if we're in a predicament where you have to protect yours and I got to protect mine, then we're going to have to do it, you know what I'm saying?
Coming up.
I came in there with good intentions, right. girl.
And it just went left. But the question I need everyone to sit there and ask is, Ashley, why did it go left?
Hello. Welcome to Clinton Hardware.
Today, I'm meeting up with Joy at a hardware store because I told my husband, James Tyler, that I will be helping as far as rehabbing the basement in our home. So I was trying to get Joy to come help me pick some things out, maybe some paint.
Hello. How are you today?
All right.
Welcome to Clinton Hardware. Whoa.
Joy, help. I'm surprised you're coming to a place like this.
You're right. I would be. But I told, look, my husband has no faith in me, and I told him I want to work on this basement. Look, I was over in the paint aisle. Mm-hmm. I'm more interested in, like, paint colors and what we're going to do with it.
Okay.
So how are you and Clifton doing y'all first year?
Clifton and I are doing great. I mean, I can't say, like, anything has changed. I think what it is us now trying to just find, like, the balance.
Right.
You know, balance with, like, the group, balance with work, balance with us.
Girl, the balance with the group coming along.
You tell me, girl. You tell me. You Switzerland. What does Switzerland say? What's Switzerland's perspective?
Switzerland is scratching her head every night. Okay?
You might have to take the wig off the scratch.
Yes. I'm trying to figure this out.
I mean, yes, we were invited to come in. I came in there with good intentions, girl.
Right. And it just went left.
But the question I need everyone to sit there and ask is, Ashley, why did it go left?
The conversation was supposed to be like, why would you share personal information that you shared with her? Mm-hmm. And you guys talked about that how long? What, 5 minutes?
Not even that. It was something that she wanted to, you know, sweep under the table.
It was very unexpected.
It was. And when she brought up you and Cliff Dunn wouldn't be here if it wasn't for me. Mm-hmm. It was just kind of like, it's almost like a in your face, talking down.
Yeah, see, I don't know where that came from.
I did not like to see Joy and Ashley get into the space. Things got really heated between the two. I personally think that Joy hurt Ashley's ego, because Joy did not back down when Ashley confronted her at the Christmas Eve party.
And so when you left, mm-hmm. I went in to see what was going on with Ashley. Mm-hmm. Ashley was like going off because I went to check on you first instead of her.
One may think that this entire world revolves around Ashley. I think Ashley thinks the world revolves around Ashley. Ashley, there's other people in this world. Hello. Knock, knock. Just.
I wanted to bring us all back together and see if we could have a conversation. Mm.
But where are you with Ashley, though?
So we haven't really had a conversation. We haven't talked about the holiday party. We haven't spoken about you. I have not had a conversation with her on the phone yet to discuss anything.
Tonight is a historical moment. Maryland has elected its first black governor, Wes Moore, who happens to be a friend of ours. So I'm just honored to be the DJ for tonight's festivities.
And this ain't an event we can be late for.
We're running late as 100% always. Ashley just cannot be on time, ever.
Since I was rushed, I was not able to complete my makeup and my hair. So now I have to do my hair and my makeup in the car. Who knows how I'm gonna look when I get there? Amazing, but maybe like a little less amazing if I would've been able to do it at home.
I met with Clifton this morning.
Clifton, the big red dog.
And of course, he couldn't make it to the Christmas Eve event because he was in the hospital still. He said he's definitely not all the way back. He still got a long road to recovery.
Speedy recovery.
But after that, I had to address the elephant in the room. The blow up with Joy, his wife. Yeah. That is his wife.
I know
you've always known that, but.
I've known for months.
I said, I felt like you and Joy were becoming friendly or cordial or something. I mean, she hung out, so in my.
Yeah, she's been to the house multiple times.
In my mind, y'all were getting cool.
I've been nothing but supportive to them.
So the crazy part is, then he took it a step further. Like, I feel like maybe it's a jealousy or a rivalry thing with you and Joy.
Jealous of what?
And you're using this moment of you exposing her truth about her marriage.
This don't even make sense. So I'm jealous and using Joy.
Because you're like intimidated or something, and now you're using the sudden.
Intimidated by a wedding singer? Who the do they think they are?
Like, I don't know. They was on the game show and they mind.
Contestant green dress and contestant big teddy bear.
And in their mind, they're big stuff. What's their last name? Because I know it's the Silvers, the Tyler's. What's the
Petty?
The Petty.
That's exactly what they are.
That's their real last name.
Exactly. It's their real last name. I was about to say no shade, but all shade. Like, who are y'all?
I don't even know where this.
I mean,
logic is coming
it's
from.
It's nothing about the Petties that I want. I don't want to wear jumpsuits all the time. I don't want a unisex beard oil.
Jesus Christ, Ashley Silver.
At this point, what I do wish is I would have never brought them around.
It's going to be super bad now because at the end of the day, if my wife don't rock with somebody, I can't. So it is what it is.
Honestly, on my mind, we ain't friends. If she said we enemies, girl, all right, I'll be your enemy, child.
It ain't gonna cost us no sleep or no money.
Y'all ungrateful, y'all famous, y'all icons, y'all all these things. All right. They got it.
It is what it is.
It is what it is. Tonight is a big night. We are about to go and celebrate our friend who is the governor.
The first black elected governor, not just that.
So this is an amazing opportunity. It's historical.
Got my tux on.
These are things that I admire.
Right. Coming up.
I'm not going to do this with you because we about to get to a point of no return. Look, so I don't know why
this
never...
is really anything coming out your mouth.
Dining in or to go?
Dining in.
Dining in for two.
Yeah.
All righty.
Enjoy yourself.
Thank you so much.
No worries.
Since Christmas Eve, Arena and I really haven't talked to each other, so I wanted to reach out. I'm hoping that things can be smoothed over. We can move forward.
A mimosa, like a regular orange mimosa.
Say no more. Can you wait for me?
Hello.
Hi.
Welcome,
how are
Nookah
you?
Honey. Are you meeting someone?
Yes. All Ashley, right. I don't know if she's already here or not.
All right, you follow me.
Okay.
Here she is. Hello.
Hi. Hi. You look
pretty.
So beautiful.
It is freezing out there.
It's so cold.
I love your suit.
Thank you.
Given. Y'all get on my nerves, okay, about our accent.
I'm actually glad that Ashley called me to meet up so that we can have a conversation about the Christmas Eve party. We never had a chance to actually talk about what happened. I would love for us to get back on the right path.
Well, I haven't talked to you since the holiday party.
What I wanted to discuss is what happened with me and you. Joy, a little disrespectful ass, came up in my house. You ran out after her. That bothered me. I'm like, this
but
is my
house. But where the hell was she? I didn't even see you.
I was literally standing on the steps.
So you saw, see, how the hell am I supposed to know you were on the steps?
Man, you would have if you wouldn't have ran past
into where everybody was going. It was chaos. So First of all, it was just so much going on, I didn't even think. I was just like, okay, what the
Maybe that's what it was. Maybe you just didn't think. What I would have thought is, let me check on the person who owns this house. Let me check on the person who invited me here.
You think I'm thinking about who's owning the house or what when all this chaos is going on?
Yes, you should be thinking about
when
this is Ashley's house.
All these
house,
people yelling.
Yes,
I'm not thinking about whose house. I'm looking at whoever I could see first. It doesn't matter who's who. Now, if I saw you at the foyer, I would have been like, Ashley, what happened? What the f*** is going on? Straight to her. So then after that, I could have left. It could have been me leaving and not coming back.
You could have left. No one was stopping you. Right now, I am really wondering, like, where me and Arena, where our friendship lies. I don't know if we are as close as I thought we were.
I've argued with friends before. It happens.
What I've never had is a friend all this in my face, and that's why I kept saying to you, Raina, let's stop. Because
you know where that came from.
That's what it is.
You're doing too much.
No. You're doing less. You're not doing enough.
But you're doing too much.
You're not doing enough.
You're doing too much.
Raina, keep your hand on my face. Put your hand down. Raina, don't put your hands up to me. I'm not doing that to you.
I'm not going to do this with you because we about to get to a point of no return. I said to you, I think 3 times, stop.
Okay, but you know my temper, and you
know how I am. I know your temper, but at the same time, if I got a temper too, so if I can be like,
and that's why we were going at it, because you got a temper and I got a temper.
We don't need to do this. And I'm repeating it. That means we don't need to do that.
Look, so I don't know why I was listening. Really, anything coming out your mouth?
This season on Love and Marriage, DC.
Welcome to DC.
You know, sometimes the claws come out.
What up, now?
So, you know, I started a beard oil. So Carmen has been my PR publicist.
I mean, aren't we still a throuple?
I mean, apparently that's what everybody thinks. Carmen got a great personality. She's a good catch.
I know my wife.
Yeah.
She can be a jealous mom.
It just doesn't look right.
You did the exact same thing Carmen and Clifton did.
He got really upset about some things that happened in the past in our marriage.
Let's leave the past in the past and let's just move on.
Neither one of you are forgiven that completely.
I've been a therapist for 30 years.
I invited some of my retired buddies.
It's okay to not be okay, right?
How are you doing separating the police part with being a parent?
That's been my struggle.
Lord Jamie, he is hurting.
Why are you cussing at me, though?
Because I'm pissed.
Because
right
I'm
now.
Not about to let you keep cussing at me.
His relationship with his father reminds me a lot of the relationship that I had with my mother.
No, you weren't there.
That is a blatant lie.
Three down!
Got the guys here today to actually train with the wrestlers train.
Ah! Hosting the Wizards game tonight.
Currently, I'm jealous of Joy, but there's nothing about you, Joy, to be jealous about.
I hate that this even happened. Like, how did we even get here? Ask Ashley.
And I feel like you've kind of thrown yourself to Joy's side.
I'm actually hurt with Arena right now.
Things have been going great with Yusha so far. We're dating exclusively.
He doesn't seem like a bad person, but just continue to take your time. I feel like love can blind you at times.
We're gonna get engaged. We're gonna get married. Wanna plan a couple's trip.
Everybody under one roof. How you feeling about that?
Oh, this is cute.
So where's it gonna happen?
Like, did he hit his head? I tell my truth, do you? I tell my truth all the time.
Here come the drama.
Back the up. Let's do that real quick.
I fought bitches bigger than Clifton.
And where is your husband?
I just want to enjoy the game.
Stop talking about me right now.
I'm not talking about you.
Bye. And if I'm going to feel by myself, then I'm going to be by myself.
I've never in my life sat here and experienced such imbalance.
Who the is 40 wearing blue contacts in 2023?
What twilight zone are we in right now?
There's nothing you have added to my life. This is up.
Lord, these people crazy, Lord.
I'm the same always got your back.
I'm going home. Back